بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، جماعة المسلمين، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فسيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين، هذا بيان للناس وهدى وموعظة للمتقين، ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين، إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح مثله، وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس وليعلم الله الذين آمنوا ويتخذ منكم شهداء والله لا يحب الظالمين، صدق الله العظيم. جماعة المسلمين، indeed it is يوم الجمعة once again and we are still in our homes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may he return us to his sacred and beloved houses to be able to perform our Jumu'ah in Jama'ah, in congregation, sooner than later. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. But we are at home and we have time to ponder and reflect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَّبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمَ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Don't they ponder over the Qur'an or are there locks on their hearts? It's time for us to unlock those hearts, open those hearts, and to reflect on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, all the answers to all our questions can be found within the Holy Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا فَرَطَنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We haven't left a single thing out of the book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبِيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرًا لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. And we have revealed, most verily, this kitab, this book to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have revealed this book to you, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as an explanation for all things, and as a guidance, and as a mercy, and a glad tidings for the Muslimin, for those who are submitting and surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us open that Quran, and we're opening it to Surah Ali Imran, and we're opening it to verse number 137 to 140. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins by saying, قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنَنٌ. That indeed there has come before you sunan. What are sunan? Sunan is the plural of sunnah. And we are used to hearing sunnatu Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sunnatu nabi, the sunnah of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which are his aqwal and af'al and taqrirat, his words, his actions, his allowances, his way of life sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also has a sunnah. Sunnat Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, Sunnat Allah fi alladhina khalaw min qabl, walan tajid li sunnatillahi tabdila, walan tajid li sunnatillahi tahwila. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Sunnat Allah, the sunnah of Allah. What is the sunnah of Allah? The sunnah of Allah is the order that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created in this universe. The order on which he manages and controls this universe. Especially when it comes to us. Especially when it comes to our actions and our behavior. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah will not change the condition of a people until they change the condition of themselves. Whether it goes from good to bad, in other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not change the condition of a people from good to bad, unless they first become bad themselves. And likewise, in order to return back to good, they must become good themselves first. Because this is sunnatullah. كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانُ. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ says, اَعْمَلْ مَا شِئْتَ كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانُ. Do whatever you like, what you do will be done unto you. What you sow, you reap. مَنْ زَرَعَ حَصَدَ. Whatever you do, will be done unto you. This is sunnatullah fi al-kawn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, sunnatullah fi alladhina khalaw min qabl. The order of Allah in those who have come before. In other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made examples out of people because of their wrong actions. And because of the consequences of what they have brought upon themselves because of those actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that fasad, what is fasad? Fasad can be social or moral corruption. It could be political corruption. It could be economic corruption. It could be environmental corruption. So many forms of corruption. They have manifested themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on the land and even in the sea, because of what mankind has earned with their own hands, in order that they might taste the consequences of what they have done, and in the hope that they might repent and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is sunnatullah. It goes around and around and around. I heard one alim giving a description of the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like the lines in a record, in a vinyl record. Those tracks that go around and around and around. And history repeats itself. History repeats itself. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنَنٌ. That indeed, before you have come examples of the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. So go out in the earth. فَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَانْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ. And see what was the end result of those who belied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who rejected belief in Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla fi'ula. So many examples. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps asking this rhetorical question in the Holy Quran. Why is it a rhetorical question? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't make istifham. What's istifham? To seek understanding. لأن الله تعالى لا يطلب الفهم من أحد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't seek understanding from anyone or anything. Why? Because عَلِمَ مَا كَانَ وَعَلِمَ مَا يَكُونَ وَعَلِمَ مَا سَيَكُونَ وَعَلِمَ مَا لَا يَكُونَ وَلَوْ كَانَ كَيْفَ كَانَ يَكُونَ. Why? Because Allah knows that which was, and He knows that which is, and He knows that which will be, and He even knows that which will not be, and if it had to be, how it would be. جَلَّ فِي عُلَى اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هُمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ بَطَشًا فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ هَلْ مِنْ مَحِيصٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and how many generations before them have we destroyed? So go out in the earth. فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ. Tanqib, the word in Arabic, which basically means excavation. In other words, you can go out and look what's on top of the earth and even dig underneath and see what happened to those nations who belied and defied the commands and laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هَلْ مِنْ مَحِيصٍ؟ هَلْ مِنْ مَفِرٍ؟ هَلْ مِنْ هَارِمٍ؟ هَلْ مِنْ مُنْجِي؟ Did any of them escape? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about those whom He utterly destroyed. We think of Ad and Thamud and Fir'aun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادِ إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِبَادِ التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فصب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب إن ربك لبالمرصاد. Do you not see what Allah SWT did to Ad? وأما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصر عاتية سخرها عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما. الله الله أكبر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, and as for Ad, we destroyed them بريح صرصر عاتية, with a ريح which is صرصر, in other words, a howling عاتية, violent, a howling violent wind, 7 nights and 8 days. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says further on down in the surah, do you see any of them that have remained? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ. And Thamud, that mighty nation who hewed out of rock their homes. وفرعون ذي الأوتاد, فرعون firmly established in the earth. وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد. What did they do? They were tyrannical in the earth. They caused a lot of, they were oppressive, and they caused great corruption. الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the whip of punishment upon them. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ بِالْمِرْصَادِ. Indeed, your Lord is ever watchful. You know, sometimes, you know, we sit and we see all the evil that's been happening in the world, especially, you know, since the last pandemic, you know, the Spanish flu, 1918, 500 million contracted it, between 50 and 100 million died. And we see in this last 102 odd years, you know, how much evil, how much oppression, how much suppression, how much corruption has been permeating through the earth. And then we wonder to ourselves why, you know, why these things happen. Allahu Akbar. Allah is watching. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا أَمَّا يَعْمَلَ الظَّالِمُونَ. Do not think that Allah is unaware of what the oppressors are doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُمْلِلُ الظَّالِمُ حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتُ. Indeed, Allah gives respite to the oppressor, but when he takes him, there's no escaping. There's no escaping. So, what did we expect? Could the earth continue to go on as it's been going for the last 100 years? Abadan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran of these sunan, of examples that he's made of people that have come before. وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هَلْ تَحِسُّ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا أَوْ تَسْمَعُ لَهُمْ رِكْزًا. And how many generations have we destroyed before them? You know, do you feel the presence of any of them? Or do you even hear a sound of them? Riks is the arrowhead. You know, when it enters the body, it's hidden. You know, so it's the word that is used to describe a sautul khafi. You know, even the slightest sound. Do you hear it of them? No, khalas. Minhum qa'imun wa hasid. You know, some of those places that we go out in the earth and we see the Roman ruins and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed those empires, but some of their ruins have remained. But some of them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has totally flattened. There's not even a trace of them anywhere in the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this, you know, as a what? As a reminder. You know, as a sign. وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ. And the taking of your Lord. إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَى. When he takes these towns and these places. وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَىٰ وَهِيَ ظَالِمًا. When these places are committing oppression, committing evil and corruption. إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Indeed, his destruction of these places is painful and is severe. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً لِمَنْ خَافَ عَذَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. Indeed, in this there is a sign for those who fear the punishment of the hereafter. So there are places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has totally destroyed. And there are also punishments that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down where he doesn't totally destroy, but he sends a punishment on the dunya. It's called the small punishment, before the big punishment on the Day of Judgment, the Day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, in order that the people should wake up and return to Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And we shall give them a taste of the small punishment before the big punishment, in the hope that they should wake up and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been quite specific with regards to some of the causes and reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends these so-called small punishments. I mean, compared to people that were utterly destroyed, look at the tufan of Nabi Nuh alayhi salam. You know, ففتحنا أبواب السماء بماء منهمر وفجرنا الأرض عيونا فالتقى الماء على أمر قد قدر وحملناه على ذات ألواح ودسر. And we opened the doors of the heavens and brought down great torrential rain. And we turned the whole earth into a gigantic spring. And the two waters met on a matter decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we carried him, Nabi Nuh alayhi salam, Prophet Noah and his people, the believers that were with him, on something made of planks and nails. You know, planks and nails won't save you. But it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that saved them. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that sent the storm, sent the flood, and destroyed everyone and everything on earth, except for Nabi Nuh and his people. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُمُ الْبَاقِينَ. And we made his progeny the only survivors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent punishments before that have totally destroyed nations. Here is a punishment, and we can clearly see that it is to wake us up from our state of heedlessness and carelessness. Yes, we have discussed before that calamities are different things to different people. To the oppressor, it is a punishment. To the that can take totally destroy them. To the one that is heedless and careless, it is a small punishment to wake them up. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ, in hope that they might return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the believer, it is even a means of purification, a means of drawing ever closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, with regards to some of the causes that bring about such diseases, and the pandemic at that, in other words, it afflicts everyone. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, لَمْ تَظْهَرِ الْفَاحَشَةُ فِي قَوْمٍ قَبْتْ حَتَّى يُعْلِنُوا بِهَا إِلَّا فَشَ فِيهِمُ الطَّاعُونَ وَالْأَوْجَاءُ. That never ever does promiscuity manifest itself in a society until they're doing it in the open. No one shudders to think, to what degree promiscuity, homosexuality, pornography has become so, widespread all over the world. What do we expect? We expect it to have no consequences? No, our beloved Prophet ﷺ says, never ever does promiscuity manifest itself in a people until they are doing it in the open, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send plagues and famine upon them, like he has on the previous generations. And the promiscuity of today is nothing like the promiscuity of yesterday. I mean, there might have always been promiscuity, but, it was mostly done, behind closed doors. Now it is done in the open. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a punishment that will, the small punishment that Allah speaks about, to wake people up. Not to destroy them completely, to wake them up. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will, under certain circumstances, He will send it upon all the people. That's why, whether they be believers or disbelievers, whether they be rich or poor, whether they be, politicians or street sweepers, whether they be academics or uneducated, it doesn't matter. Black or white, Arab or Turk, American or Australian, it doesn't matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a hadith, he says, لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَوْ لَيُشْرِكَنَّ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِقَابًا مِنْهُ ثُمَّ لَتَدْعُونَهُ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابَ لَكُمْ. You must enjoin the good and forbid the evil. Because if you don't, then it just might be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send upon a punishment from Him upon all of you. And then you will, even the believers, you'll pray to Him and their prayers will not be answered. How much evil is being perpetrated in the world, and everybody, or a lot of people, if not most people, are looking the other way. People are not saying anything. There is apathy, there is indifference. And in fact, there's a sequence to this, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this is again the sunnah of Allah. The sunnah of Allah, direct consequence of our actions. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَتَعْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفُ وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَإِلَّا لَيُسَلِّطَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ شِرَارَكُمْ فَيَدَعُوا خِيَارَكُمْ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ. You must enjoin the good and forbid the evil. Because if you don't, Allah will send the worst of you to rule over you, and then the best of you will make dua, and the du'as will not be answered. So look at the sequence. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا أَرَدْنَا أَن نُهْلِكَ قَرْيَةً أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا فَحَقَّ عَلَيْهَا الْقَوْلُ فَدَمَّرْنَاهَا تَدْمِيرًا. And if you want to destroy a people, the first thing, we put the worst of them in power over them. And then, what do? فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا. And because it's the worst of them, they do the worst of things. Evil and corruption becomes prevalent and manifest. Until فَحَقَّ عَلَيْهَا الْقَوْلَ, and then they become deserving of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment. فَدَمَّرْنَاهَا تَدْمِيرًا, and then we utterly destroy them. Allahu Akbar. So, the fact that this is happening now, this is a mercy. And you know, it's not discriminating. It's not, there's no prejudice here. Coronavirus is not a racist. Coronavirus is not an Islamophobe. Coronavirus is not a, you know, anti-Semitic. Coronavirus is not anti-Christian or anti-anything. Muslims are getting this. The first four doctors in the UK to pass away were four Muslim doctors. So, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُسِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصًا. And fear a trial that will not only afflict those who are oppressing amongst you. You know, this is coming. It will not only afflict the oppressors. It is afflicting all of us, the good and the bad. And as long as we are following righteous guidance, then no matter what, now, even if death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all long life in His obedience, ameen, that even if death had to take us, that it'll be something good for us. Ya alladhina amanu alaykum anfusakum la yadurrukum man dalla idha ihtadaytum. Oh, those of you who believe, you know, take care of yourselves. In other words, make sure that you're on the right path. Make sure that you are on the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying His laws and commandments, you know, enjoining the good, forbidding the evil, staying away from haram, staying away from all that which is prohibited and unlawful. As long as you are, عليكم لا يضركم من ضل, those who are misguided, those who are doing wrong, can bring no harm upon you as long as you are being rightly guided. You know, because even, you know, the believer who is steadfast, even in this time of affliction, because it's afflicting the whole world, all 197 countries, you know, it's a pandemic. Pan, which means all, demos, meaning people, the Greek pandemos, all the people, it's afflicting all the people of every nation everywhere. So even the believer that is taken in this time, look at the words of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam: "Man mata fi at-ta'am fa huwa shaheed." Whoever dies in a plague, then he's a martyr in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But still we make dua, you know, every morning. Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama'i wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. You know? With the name of Allah, with which no harm can come in the heavens or on earth, and He is all hearing and all knowing. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. I seek refuge in the perfect words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all that He has created which is harmful. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. You know, recite the Surah Al-Ikhlas and Al-Mu'awwadhatayn. You know, قل والله أحد قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. يعني تكفيك من كل شيء. You know, it will be, serve as a protection, inshallah, from all harm, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for that person to leave this world. Then there's, you know, Allah yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the souls at the time of death. You know, because ultimately we believe, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ajaban lil-mu'min amru kulluhu khayr. The matter of the believer, it's all good. In asabahu sarra shakar fa kana khayran lahu. If something good happens, he gives thanks, he shows gratitude, and it's good for him. وإن أصابه الضراء, and if something harmful befalls him, صبر, he's patient and persevering in the obedience of Allah, in abstaining from the disobedience of Allah, in the time of trial and tribulation, فكان خيرا له, and it's also good for him. So, Jamaat al-Muslimin, no matter what is happening, the entire thing is affecting everybody around the world. You know, either, you know, people who are getting sick, people are being hospitalized, people are dying, thousands are dying, over a million are infected now. More than 50,000 have died. And we must take all the cause. We must tie the camel. أَعْقِلْهَا وَتَوَكَّلْ. That's why we are staying at home. That's why we can't even go to the masajid. Tie your camel and put your trust in Allah. لَا يُرِدُ مُرِدْ عَلَى الْمَسِحِ. That the sick one must not come into contact with the health. We are taking all the causes. We are putting our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَعْقِلْهَا فَتَوَكَّلْ. Tie your camel and put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But as long as we are rightly guided, no matter what is going to happen, no matter what is going to be the final outcome of this, it will be good for the believers. بِإِذْنِ ta'ala al-wahid, al-wahid dayyan. So let's go back to Surah Ali Imran. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made many examples of many nations that have come before you. So go out on the earth and see what happened to those who belied and denied and rejected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هَذَا بَيَّرُ لِلنَّاسِ. This is a clear sign. Allahu Akbar. Wow. How more clearer can it be? You know, how more clearer can it be how weak and vulnerable and susceptible and incompetent, incapable and dependent we are, and how almighty and absolute and self-subsisting and all independent is our creator and sustainer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is hadha bayanu linnas. This is a clear sign for all people. Who can bring the entire world to its knees? You know, who can shut down an entire economy? Who can lock down more than 3 billion people? Probably more now. Every day we hear about a new lockdown in a new country. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla fi ala. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاء وَيَخْتَارُ مَا كَانَ لَهُمَ الْخِيَرَةُ. And indeed, your Lord creates whatever He wants. He created this army. He created this coronavirus. And He chooses how to spread it in this world and what to do with it in terms of waking up the world and opening their eyes and bringing them to some sort of realization that the way that they've been living is just wrong and it cannot continue. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا كَانَ لَهُمَ الْخِيَرَةُ. Mankind, He didn't make this. You know, this coronavirus, you know, the protein spikes have got a key on it. You know, for the lock on the human cell. And only the one who created the lock can give the key. This is from Allah. هَذَا بَيَانٌ لِلنَّاسِ وَهُدًى وَمَوْعِظَةٌ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. So, this is a clear wake-up call for the entire world. And it is a guidance and a mu'idha. Mu'idha is more of a gentle reminder for those who fear their Lord, for those who want to shield themselves from the displeasure of their Lord. And this is just an extra sort of, you know, get ready, repent, return, wake up. Mu'idha lil muttaqin, from the word taqwa, which means a shield, because the muttaqi places a shield between themselves and all types of behavior that will bring upon them the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. You know, Allah Ta'ala is now speaking to the believers. You know, don't despair. Don't be sad. وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ. You know, you will come out of this. You know, you'll be on top. أَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ. You know, إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are true believers. If you are true believers. We did that hadith earlier. عَجَبًا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ أَمْرُ كُلُّ خَيْرٍ. The matter of the believer, it's all good. It's all good. You'll come out on top. As long as you are steadfast in your belief, in your faith. يَمْسَسْكُمْ قَرْحٌ. If you're injured, فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُ. You know, other people, other nations far more pious and far more greater than us, in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have been through worse. You know, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمْ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do you think you're just going to go to paradise just like that? And there hasn't yet come to you the example of those who came before you? Far more pious and greater nations with messengers and prophets amongst them. And how they were afflicted with trials and tribulations. Do you think you're going to enter paradise? And there hasn't yet come to you the like of those that came before you. They were afflicted with مَسَّتُمُ الْبَأْسَاءَ وَالضَّرَّاءَ. They were afflicted with poverty and ill health. وَزُلْزِلُوا. And adversity, that they were, to the degree that they were shaken. حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. Until the messenger that was amongst them and those who believed that were with him, they said, when is the help of Allah coming? And Allah reminds us, أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Indeed, the help of Allah is near. Don't worry. Be patient. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلِفْ لَا مِمْ أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. وَلَقَدَ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alif Lam Mim, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسِ. Does mankind think, you know, أَن يُتْرَكُوا, that they're going to be left alone after they have said, we believe. وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ, and they're not going to be tested. And indeed we tested those who came before them, in order that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might make manifest who are those who have fulfilled their covenant with Allah. And who have those who have broken and belied their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then further on down in Surah Al-Ankabut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. In order that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might expose and make manifest who are the true believers and who are the hypocrites. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us of the munafiqeen. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. You know, Jamaat al-Muslimin, you know, up till now, you know, for the last 100 years, you know, since the last pandemic, so many atrocities, so much wrong, so much evil has been perpetrated. And We've even been asking ourselves, you know, how long can this go on for? And as mentioned earlier, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُمْلِي لِلظَّالِمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives respite to the oppressor. حَتَّى إِذَا أَخِذَهُ لَمْ يُفْلِتُ. But when Allah takes him, there's no getting away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ إِنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِثْمًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَذَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَلَى مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ حَتَّى يَمِيزَ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and let the disbelievers not think for one second that we give them rope, we give them scope, you know, for their benefit. No, we only give them rope and scope that they might increase in sin. Now, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them so many warnings, giving them so many chances, and they persist in their evil, you know, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبَوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى إِذَا فَرِحُوا بِمَا أُوتُوا أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بَغْتَةً فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبْلِسُونَ. Until they forgot about, or until they ignored about that which they were forewarned. Until they ignored about that which they were forewarned. We opened the doors of everything for them. You want it? Take it. You've been given so many chances. You don't want to listen? Right, take it. Allah gives them that respite. He gives them that scope. He gives them that rope. You know? Until they were overjoyed with that which they received, we suddenly seized them and they were shrouded in great regret and sorrow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ إِنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِثْمًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. For them will be a humiliating punishment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns to the believers and says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَذَرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَلَى مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ. And Allah will never leave you believers in the situation that you are in. حَتَّى يَمِيزَ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ. Until the wretched has been separated from the righteous. And that's been made known and manifest. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and guide us all. So, Jamaat al-Muslimin, هذا بيان للناس وهدى وموعظة للمتقين إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح مثله وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس وليعلم الله الذين آمنوا ويتخذ منكم شهداء والله لا يحب الظالمين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِيَّمْ سَسْكُمْ قَرْحٌ فَقَدَ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُهُ. If you're injured, others have been injured before you. Those were even more pious than what you are, and did more good than what you did, but yet they were still afflicted. إِذَا حَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا إِبْتَلَاهُ. If Allah loves a servant, He tests that servant. الْأَنْبِيَاءُ شَدُّ بَلَاءً. The prophets of Allah are the most tested of Allah's creation. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. Then those who follow them in rank, and then those who follow them in rank. وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And these are the days we circulate amongst the people. You know, the days that people are feeling so strong and feeling so mighty and feeling so wealthy and feeling so everything. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just pulls the rug from under their feet. You know, and likewise the believers, you know, there's been times also when we've been strong and we have, you know, had authority and we've had a voice, and, you know, and there's been times where we have absolutely, you know, we're not even considered. You know, a time which our beloved Prophet warned us of, you know, that يُوشِكُ أَن تَتَدَاعَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأُمَمُ كَمَا تَتَدَاعَ الْأَكَلَةُ إِلَى قَصَعَتِهَا قِيلَ أَوَمِنْ قِلَّةٍ نَحْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ قَالَ بَلْ أَنْتُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ كَثِيرٌ وَلَكِنَّكُمْ غُثَاءٌ كَغُثَاءِ السَّيْلِ يَنْزِعُ اللَّهُ الرُّعْبَ مِنْ قُلُوبِ أَعْدَائِكُمْ وَيُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ الْوَهْنَ. قَالُوا وَمَا الْوَهْنُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا وَكَرَاهِيَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ says, there will come a time when the nations of this world will be preying on you. P-R-E-Y-I-N-G. Praying. You know, like the eaters at a feast, eat off one plate of food. You know, just grabbing, you know, Palestine, Afghanistan, Iraq. Allahu Akbar. Syria. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. The Sahaba asked, is it because of our small numbers on that day? He said, no, your numbers will be many, but you'll be like the foam of a flood water. You know, when water comes through the valley in the desert, it carries all that debris with it. You know, the water is strong and powerful, but the debris it's a lot, but it's weak, and it just gets pushed wherever the water goes. Oka hutha il bahar, or like the foam of the waves in the sea. You know, it's a lot, but it just goes wherever the water pushes it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the fear of you from the hearts of your enemy. Your enemy won't be scared of you. They'll do with you whatever they want to. And he will enter into your hearts wahan. And he put wahan into your hearts. They asked, what is wahan, O Messenger of Allah? He said, the love of this world and the hatred of death. Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر. وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس. So these are the days we circulate amongst the people. We were strong. Now we're weak. Maybe inshallah we'll be strong again one day. Inshallah. And rule with justice and rule with goodness and with fairness, with love and mercy and compassion. Restore it to this world, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. It reminds me of the story of Abu Darda when they were, after they had taken some of the islands in the Mediterranean, and it was a day of victory, day of celebration, but Abu Darda was sitting and he was crying. And so one of the Sahaba came and asked him, "Atabki yawm an-nasr ya Abu Darda? Do you cry on the day of victory, ya Abu Darda?" And he said, "Naam, yes I do." He said, "Walima, why?" He said, "Abki li hali ha'ula an-nas." He said, "I'm crying for the condition of those people." And he pointed to the disbelievers whom the Muslimin had defeated. "Lamma asu Allah, makkana Allah min riqabin fantasarna alayhi." He said, "When they disobeyed Allah, Allah strengthened us and gave us victory over them." وَأَخْشَ أَيَأْتِ الْيَوْمُ الَّذِي نَعْسِ اللَّهَ فِيهِ فَيُمَكِّنُهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ رِقَابِنَا فَيَنْتَصِرُونَ عَلَيْنَا. And I fear the day when we shall disobey Allah, and then Allah will strengthen them and grant them victory over us. Allah. Who knows? Maybe this is a turning point. Inshallah. We will. Our dignity and our honor will be restored to us as a people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return the greatness to us that He gave to the companions of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because they made Islam great. What it said in Umar say when he came, you know, in front of the Patriarch of Jerusalem to receive the keys, and he was wearing a thobe with 17 patches, and he was walking whilst his servant was riding on his camel, and Abu Ubaidah said, "Ya Amir al-Mu'minin, ya laytika labista al-abaya. Oh Amir al-Mu'minin, if only you had worn your cloak, you know, to cover the patches. Ya laytika rakibta al-ba'ir. If only you had ridden on your camel, you know, you're going to meet the Patriarch of Jerusalem." He said, "Oh Abu Ubaidah, if anybody else had said what you said." He said, "Ya Abu Ubaidah, nahnu qawmun azzana Allah bil Islam, fa kullama abtaghayna al-izzata bighayrihi adhallana Allah." He said, "Abu Ubaidah, we are a people that Allah has made great with Islam, and every time we have sought greatness in anything but Islam, Allah has brought us down and humiliated us." Allah. Wa tilka al-ayyam nudawiluha bayna. See, these are the days that we circulate amongst the people. One day up, next day down. In order that Allah might know who are the true believers, to test us, who are the ones of true faith. وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. In the process, it takes martyrs from you. How many Muslims have died in the last century? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our shuhada, accept our martyrs. Ameen ya Rabbi. وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah loves not the oppressors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith Qudsi, إِنِّي حَرَمْتُ الظُّلْمَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي وَجَعَلْتُهُ بَيْنُكُمْ مُحَرَّمًا فَلَا تَظَالَمُوا. Indeed, I have prohibited myself from oppressing, and I have prohibited you from oppressing each other, so do not oppress. Too much oppression for too long. And those oppressed people, how many du'as have made against the oppressor? Who knows that what's happening now isn't but an answer of the du'as of the prayers of the oppressed. For indeed our beloved Prophet ﷺ warns and says, اتقوا دعوة المظلوم فإنها مستجابة ولو بعد حين ولو كان كافرا وعليه كفر. Beware of the prayer of the oppressed person, for indeed it is answered by Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it be after a while. Even if that oppressed person be a disbeliever, they will be answerable for their disbelief. I end with the words of the poet. He says, لَا تَظْلِمَنَّ إِذَا مَا كُنْتَ مُقَتَدِرًا فَالظُّلْمُ تَرْجِعُ قُبَاهُ إِلَى النَّدَمِ تَنَامُ عَيْنَاكَ وَالْمَظْلُومُ مُنْتَبِئٌ يَدْعُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَيْنُ اللَّهِ لَمْ تَنَمِ. He says, don't oppress if you cannot bear the consequences of your oppression. Whether it be self-oppression, which is transgressing the boundaries of Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or oppression to another one. Don't oppress if you cannot bear the consequences of oppression. For indeed, the consequences of oppression will end up in bitter regret. Your eyes will go to sleep at night while the oppressed person is awake, praying on you. And the eye of Allah never sleeps. And the eye of Allah never sleeps. Jalla fi ula. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala causes human beings to wake up. And as believers, to be even more mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and to repent and to return to Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this calamity from us and to restore our masajid to us, His sacred and beloved houses, Jalla fi ula, and that bi'idhnillahi ta'ala we might reap the good out of this difficult and trying situation. I leave you all in the protection of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.